The scientific method is the method or process by which anyone systematically draws a reasonable conclusion that is then shared with others. The short version of the scientific method is observation, reason, and experiment. And our focus today will be on the reason part. The scientific method is comprised of several parts, the first of which is having made some observation of some phenomenon. An observation is something that you can detect. You see, you hear, you smell, you taste, you feel, you can measure it. An observation is often something that is both measurable and repeatable. A phenomenon in a scientific context is something that is observed to occur or to exist. This meaning contrasts with the understanding of the word in its general use as something extraordinary or outstanding. Our focus here will be on the scientific use of the word phenomenon when we are talking about something singular, or phenomena when we are talking about something plural. A few examples of natural phenomena include things like gravity, the moon, wind, clouds, a baby laughing, cheese molding, rubber slipping on concrete, or a pendulum veering off course. The list is endless and continues to grow every day. The first step in the scientific method is to make the observation of some phenomenon. You can make the observation many times from many different angles. Then, the next step is to reason it out. Think about it, in other words. What could it be? How can you safely set up some experiments to test what it could be? We are now entering the wild and crazy phase of the scientific method. As the great philosopher Ludwig Wittgenstein said, if people didn't do stupid stuff, smart stuff wouldn't happen. Most simply put, a hypothesis is a prediction statement, or an educated guess. A hypothesis is when you sort of go out on the limb to say or write what you believe the phenomenon to be. You could say that it's the guessing phase of things. A few examples are, the ancients observed that some of the stars in the night sky wandered and were not fixed. They guessed that these few stars in the night sky that moved around were being pushed by angels flapping their wings. This hypothesis has been updated a little bit since then. Many people today believe that the rain makes it cooler, but that's not exactly correct. The cooler part is what makes it rain. Many people believe that insects are attracted to light, but that's not exactly correct. The light confuses the insect, and it circles the light until it bumps into it, and then it just hangs out, dazed and disoriented, blinded by the light. Many people believe that air conditioners make cold air, but that's not correct. Air conditioners move heat elsewhere, and the byproduct of that is that the air has less heat in it. These are all phenomena. The planet's moving, it raining, bugs flying, and air conditioners moving the heat outside. Careful study and testing have helped us better learn what's really going on. Recently, you were asked to make some observations. Select one, the one that you feel is the best one, and explain the observation. Then explain your guess, you know, as to what it was, your hypothesis. And then map out a plan as to what your test or test could be that you could construct to check your hypothesis. This is why we call it the reasoning out phase. These are a few things to consider when you are in this phase. Is it safe? Is what you're planning on doing safe? That is there a chance that anyone could get hurt or things could be damaged? Is it ethical? That is, could it cause other damages to people or animals? Is it reasonable? That is, does it make good use of your resources? Is it feasible? Is the cost within budget, and does it look like it might be successful? And do others agree with your thought process? So, what is the assignment? Define your observation, define your hypothesis, and propose a way to test your hypothesis that meets the criteria of being safe, ethical, reasonable, and feasible.